So George, can you start by telling me a little bit about Relo? Because I know you're here on behalf of Relo. So who are you guys and what brings you to the conference?
Oh, thank you very much for asking. So Relo is the Regional English Language Office. We are part of the United States Department of State, and we are based at the American Embassy in Budapest. The R stands for regional because while we are based in Budapest, we are responsible for Central and Southeastern Europe. So we cover from Budapest 17 countries.
17?
17.
Wow.
But of course, we're very happy to be based here in Hungary.
What's one country maybe I wouldn't think you're covering?
My gosh, wow, that's a terrible question. We cover everything from the Baltics to the Balkans, essentially.
Okay.
So. And everything in between. So from Estonia to Albania, from Romania to Slovenia.
Wow, okay. But you're based in Budapest?
We are definitely very much based in Budapest.
Okay.
It's essentially our hub.
Uh-huh.
And so we do quite a number of programs here in Hungary, but of course we have to divide our time and have quite a lot of programs in all of these other countries. And
okay.
I'll be happy to tell you about some of those programs.
Okay, we'll get there in a bit. First, tell me what brings you to this conference.
Great question. Number one, I am myself an English teacher by background. As the Regional English Language Officer, I was brought into this position because of my background in English teaching. So while I am working at the American Embassy, I am doing so as a diplomat, but as a diplomat who is a former English teacher. So our mandate as the Regional English Language Office is to help support English language teachers and learners of English in this region to help them to go about what it is they're trying to achieve. And in the case of teachers, to better teach English. In the case of learners, of course, to acquire English skills. And so this is what we're trying to do. We do this through a range of different exchange programs where we invite American teachers of English to come and support English programming in our region. We do this by sending teachers of English from this region to the United States for professional development opportunities. And we also sponsor a number of professional development opportunities, including conferences, which goes more directly to the question that you just asked me about what we're doing here. We are one of the sponsors of this particular conference, and our sponsorship includes bringing in one of our renowned speakers, an American who's going to focus on English for the environment, essentially, which ties into the theme of this conference.
This is going to be the closing plenary, isn't it, on Sunday?
It is going to be the closing plenary, but she's also giving a workshop on that day, and we have a number of materials as well that...
I remember looking at the workshop abstract thinking I should definitely go there because it was about green issues and how to raise awareness, which I think is something that Hungarian kids really need a lot of because I don't think they are growing up in a very environmentally conscious way. Some of them, a lot of them.
Well, yes and no. I mean, I think we're all trying to introduce these areas, environmental awareness being one, and other global issues. I think that's sort of what this conference speaks to. And Hungarian children probably could stand to be introduced to more of these areas. And there are a lot of efforts towards this end, actually. Yesterday, I attended a conference here given by the Regional Environmental Center, which covers about the same countries that I do, actually. Mm-hmm. It's not a U.S. government entity. It is a nonprofit, a non-governmental organization. But they gave a wonderful introduction on how to introduce these same types of issues into the English language classroom and talked about their Green Pack, for example.
Mm.
So, you know, there are a lot of other efforts towards this end that recognize this need, this gap. We're trying to work towards that same goal.
So if someone is interested in this, but they couldn't make it to the conference here in Veszprém, then is there any other way that they can take advantage of your colleague Jane being here?
So, yeah, we have Jane Petring here for 6 weeks, in fact. And,
right.
And when I say here, I mean here in my region.
17
actually.
Countries.
Actually in 5 of the 17 countries.
Okay.
Last week, she started her marathon tour in Albania. And was all around the country working with REC, who I just referred to, and my colleagues at the American Embassy there and, mm-hmm. and the American Corners down there. And worked with a number of English teachers on introducing innovative ways of integrating these environmental themes into the classroom. So as the next leg of her tour, she's right here in Budapest, in Hungary, where, you know, of course, she's here at the conference today and this weekend. But next week, she will be continuing her tour around the country, including stops in Eger, Budapest, Pécs, and Debrecen.
Oh, okay.
So we will be stopping at the American Corners in all of these cities and visiting a primary school in all of these cities as well, where she'll be giving some model lessons and how to do exactly what we're trying to introduce.
And these events are open to people who want to come along and watch, right?
The school events are going to be limited to the teachers and students who are at the schools.
Okay,
these
that respective makes sense.
Schools, but the American Corner events, these are teacher training events, and these are going to be open workshops. They do require pre-registration, so anybody who's interested should contact the either our office in Budapest or the American Corner in those respective countries and get their name on the registration list, and they'll, you know, we'll be happy to welcome as many people as can fit in the space. I should add that as part of this event, we are planning a number of follow-up projects to this tour, which I'll continue talking about in a moment. But as part of the Hungarian leg of the program, all the teachers who do attend her workshops will mm-hmm. be eligible to participate in a competition. That we will
Ooh,
have a lesson planning competition, sort of giving them asking them to consider these issues and to try and figure out some creative ways to actually implement these ideas into their classes. And there will be some incentives provided to those who
Can
do
you
participate.
Talk about these at this point, or not yet?
They will be wonderful incentives that I think the majority of people who are competing would be very interested in winning.
Okay.
I will go into further detail at a future date.
Okay, as a last question, sorry, you
sure.
wanted to say something else about the tour?
Beyond Hungary, of course, we'll be going on to Poland, followed by Estonia, and then finishing up in Slovakia. So again, this is a 6-week tour, and she's introducing these ideas across the region here. We're very excited about it. I mean, this is one of the reasons that we are very much interested in this, in addition to it being relevant in the area. This is a State Department priority right
yeah.
now. The American Department of State is very much interested in trying to help foster environmental awareness across the board here. And so that, you know, this is a way of us to bring together English teaching and this particular issue. This is only one of the issues and one of the programs that our office works on. We have a number of other exciting programs.
If people who are watching this video would like to find out more about the programs that you offer, what's the easiest way? Where can they find information about you?
Great. So the easiest way would be to go to our website, relobudapest.usembassy.gov, or simply
Are you guys on Facebook?
Google Relo. Relo Budapest, which would probably take you to our website or our Facebook page. Yes, we do have one. We have a Twitter feed as well. We would invite people to sign up for those to find out about all of our programs, and including the Green English Tour that I just referred to, the big English for Journalists project that we're working on right now, again, across the region in 10 countries. Some upcoming Learnathon events that we're going to be sponsoring next year, and a number of other exciting programs that I think a lot of teachers would be very interested in participating in.
Well, I'm definitely intrigued, and we'll check out a lot of this, and I'm sure so will be the people who are watching the video. So thanks a lot for that. That was really useful. Thank
you. My pleasure.